till the feeling hits. Maybe I just haven't let it sink in. For 3 years we were living together. Held me like you'd hold me forever. Didn't think that heart.
Hi guys, so good evening. Good evening and welcome back to my magical world. I am Frostbite, and if you don't know yet, yeah, that's my name. Okay, so I think let's just move on with our lives as usual, and we proceed and put our energy on other things that are more important, because the judgment day has come. Yeah, and yeah, it's okay. I mean, yeah. So let's start again today. Our topic will be about when to keep your mouth shut. Okay, so as you know, our mouth is one of the most powerful thing we can do. It is the most powerful thing that we have, because it can verbally kill you, right? You know, and yeah, basically that's it. So there are times that we really need to shut, you know, that you really need to shut your mouth. Okay, so I'm gonna teach you when will be that time. Okay, so it says here, this is biblical, guys. Okay, so we must follow this. This is to keep our world, you know, this earth, this universe, and the human being overall to be like in a better state. Okay, so don't open your mouth in the heat of anger. You know how it is so easy to get mad when your language, when you have like a foul language. You know, there's always an exception if it's sarcasm or whatever, but overall, do not, you know, because it's already like a heated argument. So don't don't open your mouth. Instead, shut it off and learn when to open it. Okay? When to spill the right teas, the right words. Okay? That's why my helmet for today, this is like so cute. So, right? It's so cute. I love it, actually. You see? It has like flower on top. So, we must say the words that are loving, caring, and, you know, align with our heart's desires, the good things. Okay, all the lovely things. Next is, yeah, you don't open your mouth when you don't have all the facts. It is important to be logical, reasonable, and valid. If you have all the facts around you, like all the necessary data that you need before opening your mouth, it's not okay to take one side of the story. It's not good if you just take one side of the story. Okay, so yeah, next is, if your words will offend a weaker brother. So if you know that is you are more of like a dominant ahead in life, if you are extremely like in a position where you are powerful, so don't spill words that would probably hate, you know, a weaker brother, because they're already weak, right? Why kill them with words? Okay, so yeah, be kind, guys. Okay, next is when you haven't verified the story. So actually, guys, there are verses here with that. I think I'm gonna include that at the end. Okay, so next is when you don't when you haven't verified the story, you don't know yet, it's not sure yet. Okay? So, make sure that all your facts, but that it is a fact and it is verified and you know that it is true. Okay, guys? So, yeah. Next is, if your words will be a poor reflection of the Lord or your friends and family. So, if you'll have, if it's not good to your family, to your friends, even if it's really hurtful, just don't say it, guys, because it will reflect, it will, believe me, it will reflect not just you, but on your family, because we all have a reputation here, right? And it, whatever that comes out with our mouth reflects our true nature, where we came from, right? So make sure, guys, again, to be, to behave, to act like, say, like a decent human being as you are, because you are a decent human being, diba? So I'm just saying, okay, let's proceed. When you are tempted to joke about sin, okay, people love to do this. I'm guilty also. When you are tempted to joke about sin, yeah. Next is, I'm not gonna explain that to you. You already know that. It's a joke and it's a sinful joke. Next is when you would be ashamed of your words later. When you know that your words, will you will regret saying that later on. Just, you know, swallow your words. Swallow it and put it on your tummy, okay? So, yeah. So, it's like that. Next is when you're tempted to make light. You should shut your mouth when you're tempted to make light of holy things. Holy things are not to be, you know, you don't have to say anything about it. Don't make a joke out of it, because it's a holy thing, like, you know, our Lord. So, the God, the source, whatever, guys, you should, there are times that we need to really respect, you know, certain beings. I don't need to tell you that, you should know that already before you have seen it, but in case you don't know yet, I am here to remind you again to be a decent human being. Okay, if you are not like a decent human being, you must wear something like this, diba? Like this helmet, because it will keep your mouth shut automatically. Next is, if your words would convey a wrong impression, if you think that you will be misunderstood, misinterpret any misinformation, yeah, if you, the one that you are talking to, will not understand, just don't say it to them, okay? Truth are easily get twisted, so make sure to say it in a manner that it would be amazing, okay? Next is, if the issue is none of your business, don't be nosy on other people's life and business, okay? So, yeah, absolutely amazing if it's if you are not like that kind of person, the one who is nosy or chismosa here in ano, in us, the word chismosa. Are you chismoso or chismosa, like that? Next is, when you are tempted to tell an outright lie, when you are going to tell lies, there are a lot of people, manipulative people, liars here that are, that, you know, when they speak, they act so truthfully, but in fact, they spread lies, and people and crazy people just believe in them. So make sure, guys, to filter out information that you are receiving on a daily basis, because not everything truth are usually being covered and covered and covered, and it's really hard now to believe what that is. So yeah, I'm just saying, guys, to, you know, just saying to don't spread lies. Next is, if your words will damage someone's reputation, leave it alone with other people or with God, or, you know, I don't know, guys, but if it's not too much, I mean, if it's not too grave, like the sin, don't ruin other people's reputation. It's really hard to get back on your feet. Like, our names are easily get tinted if someone is, like, mad to us or anything like that. But, yeah, I'm just saying that don't damage for the sake of just damaging. Next is, if your words will destroy a friendship, okay? So, personally, I've told you that I'm receiving left and right, you know, truth about people, but I'm not spreading it. All the secrets are here, embedded in my genes, and I will carry it until the day I die. Okay? Next, because people trusted me. I'm so trustworthy, guys. It's like that. People tell them their stories. They love to tell them stories of themselves, you know, confessions and all of that. Next is, when you are feeling critical, okay? Next is, if you can't speak without yelling. So, let's always be gracious and say it, communicate without yelling, because what's the point of yelling, right? How can you resolve things? Resolving matter must come in both parties, and you should meet, like, on you know, you should meet in the middle so that things will be resolved. Yelling won't help that, and you know that already. Next is, when it's time to listen. Okay, so you should shut your mouth if there is a time for you. I mean, when it is the time to listen, you don't always need to open your mouth. Okay, there are times like that. I told you before that it's better to be a great listener than an active person who is so talkative. Next is, if you have to eat your words later. Okay, so teenagers are prone to this one. Like, they say this one thing, and then later on in life, regret that. So, guys, again, please be humble. And humility. Yes, humility is really important. Don't say words that, because life may throw you up, okay? So, don't always be kind. Always be decent. And do not be boastful. Next is, if you may have, wait lang, I already said that. If you have already said it more than one time, then it becomes nagging, right? So if you already told it, don't overdo telling it over and over again, diba? So, because it will sound like a nag. If you tell it already, the person heard it, right? So you don't need to overdo it. Diba? You will sound like sirang plaka. Next is, when you are tempted to flatter a wicked person. You already know that person is wicked, so, and you're going to flatter them, right? Then you're both wicked together. So, those are the times that you need to really shut your mouth. Next is, when you are supposed to be working instead. So, when you're supposed to work, do your work, okay? So shut your mouth if it's not really needed, necessary. If you're not going to say words that are necessary, just shut it out, guys, okay? So we're done, guys. So those are 20 things. So I'm just gonna leave you with this a verse in the Bible from Proverbs 21 verse 23. Whosoever keepeth his mouth and his tongue keepeth his soul from trouble. So if you're just being silent all the time, I mean not all the time guys, but if you just know when to shut your mouth at the right time, right place, you will save your soul, yourself, from any trouble. Make sure guys to be to be observant, to be, you know, tactful, okay, on your words. Again, words are so powerful, our mouth is so powerful, you know that. I'm just here to remind you again of that, okay? So I'm really grateful guys that you are still with me now. It's been a year, so we're still continuing to learn every day, to love every day, to learn to love, and to move forward with our lives no matter what happened. Thank you guys for listening, and thank you for helping me make this world a better place for all of us and for the future generation. You can subscribe.
Break would feel like this. From everything to nothing at all. From every day to never at all. And everyone says that I should be sad. Is it normal that I don't feel sorry for myself? Care if your hands touch somebody else?